Check. We ready to go? Good evening and welcome to HBTV's, I just was informed that it's the fourth annual, so that was neat. Fourth annual Night of the Movies. As always, I'd like to first start off by thanking all the people that make this program possible. I want to thank Dr. Rollins for continuing to support the arts, Dr. Greep, who we value and appreciate his support as he has stepped into the role of principal this year, and the administration team for continuing to allow students opportunities to further their education. And finally, I want to thank you as parents. Your support is the reason this year was so successful. Before we begin, there's a few housekeeping items. As always, I just want to reiterate that there's no food or drink in the PAC. Second, we are recording this event tonight. If you'd like to get a copy, they are out front. We're selling them for $10 each. All the proceeds help students as they travel to competitions, as well as submit their work across the country. So please consider helping out. This is how we're able to help students in need. Our mural outside in the e-hallway, if you haven't seen it, it really is pretty special. Please go out there and take a look. It's how we showcase our students' work. These movie posters are entirely student-produced. They've shot the film, designed the poster, and we print those to help recognize their achievements. If you would like a copy of your own poster, I can get you one of those. They're $30. Just see me after tonight's concert. So with all that out of the way, let's kick this off. I created this event to help recognize the tremendous achievements that our students do on a daily basis. This year alone, we have covered over 100 live events. We've covered every football game, every basketball game for both our men's and women's teams. We've shot pep rallies, signing days, school board videos, on top of our own projects. And let's not forget about the daunting task of senior video, which is the culmination of over 250 hours of footage edited down into just 9 minutes. This group of students truly have accomplished a lot, and I can say honestly that out of all my groups of students over the years, I feel like this group has grown the most over the past 3 years. So tonight, we are here to honor their work and recognize their commitment to not only Har-Ber, but the community as well. That was done by Kylie Wright, Lindsay Flowers, and Katie Gibbs. So this year we have various awards to give out and to recognize individuals on their accomplishment throughout this year. If I call your name, please come up on stage this way as your video is playing, and after I'll give you your award. The first award of the night is our Rising Star Award. This award goes to the student that I can see has an incredible amount of potential, is passionate in either broadcast or film, and is constantly going above and beyond to get better. This student has the ability to learn quickly and creatively adapt to any situation. This enabled her to attend several advanced competitions where upperclassmen took her in as an equal, and she only excelled from there. As only a sophomore, she became a state champion and has the opportunity to represent Arkansas at the national level. I'm very proud of her work this year, and I can't wait to see what she does in the next 2 years. This year's Rising Star Award goes to Samantha Lutrell Lewandowski.
Hey, what's up, Sam?
Chris, can I see you in my office, please?
Hey, what's up, boss bro? What's poppin'? You know what you say, the third time's a charm. Are all those from Sam? Sure thing, boss man. Oh, I like that. I'm white. This thing really works. My dad loves me. My dad likes me. My dad knows I exist. Did my mom really lie to me?
Do you recall an incident involving an elevator?
Two please.
Uh-oh.
What?
We're stuck.
No, we're not. You just didn't press a button.
Well, since we're stuck, I guess I can tell you some exciting news.
Okay.
My sister's pregnant.
Really?
Yeah.
That's great.
I know. And I never thought you could be an uncle and a dad at the same time. See ya. I don't really call that one, Chief. Man, what the heck? There's no urinals in here.
Chris, what are you doing in the woman's bathroom?
I've been watching you. And I can tell, after all this time, that our love is very irresistible.
Just love? Chris, what are you talking about? Why is your shirt off? What's with the peanut butter?
Sam. Whoa, that did not happen. Dang it, this thing's broken.
Okay, and Chris, there's also something here that says you did something yesterday.
I can explain that one. Okay, my cat will be a little weird.
Look, Chris, I don't need an explanation, okay? Look, it pains me to say this. It hurts me to say this. You know who said it earlier? Third time's the charm, right? Yeah, well, three strikes in here, okay? You're fired.
No! Sam, this is all your fault!
Look, Chris, I'm sorry, but you have to be out here right now.
Fine, it's not like I wanted a job anyways. Dang, I really need a job!
Thank goodness, that freak is gone. Everybody knows his name is Shelly.
Hey, so did you want those red
sheets? It's just business casual.
About the audio, we'll figure it out. All right, we'll figure that out. Bear with us. Our next award is called our Har-Ber Excellence Award. This award goes to the person that shows what it truly means to show pride in Har-Ber while demonstrating their craft. This student is probably one of the most dedicated individuals I've ever met, and I honestly don't know where to start with this individual. If you would have told me he would be where he is today as a sophomore, I would have told you that there are several great mental health institutions we can get you into. I've never seen so much growth in a single individual as I've had with him. This year he directed over 60 live events by himself, football games, volleyball, basketball, plus many more, and I'm happy to say that he has emerged as one of the leaders of this program. This year's Har-Ber Excellence Award goes to Gentry Spresser.
Being the heart of the community means more than just getting involved. It means giving back, taking time out of your schedule, and going out of your way to make sure your city, state, or even region is a better place.
So in the Springdale community, in the greater Northwest Arkansas community, I am the director of media for the Springdale Public Schools. I also founded the Ozark Media Art Festival. And one of the main purposes that I've kind of taken on over the last 15 years is to try to build sustainable relationships between high school, college, and industry. And when I try to take my time to look at young people and say, you matter. I want you to do something important. This field is important to our communities. And most important is, you matter. I am very proud to have served for 15 years my community and trying to build opportunities for young people to connect.
It takes a passion for teaching and for students to do what Mr. Jones does, giving students the opportunity to be creative and successful in their own ways.
Trent is very passionate. He's very driven. He's a quality-oriented person, and he believes that our future is in our students, and that our success as professionals is really measured in the success of our students. Trent wants to see good things happen for good people, and he loves this place, this community, this home, and he loves the people that make it what it is. And he wants to see this community and the people in it have the very best quality of life that they can possibly have.
From starting his own film festival to creating the curriculum used across the state by all schools, Trent Jones is definitely a pillar of change and excellence in the Northwest Arkansas area and beyond. For HPWN, I'm Gentry Spresser.
Okay, one of the accomplishments that I'm most proud of every year is our episodic series called The Studio. It's quickly becoming a huge tradition to this program, as this year we produced Studio C. If you've ever watched The Office, it is exactly like that. The students write, shoot, and produce, edit, and create a final product that is around 35 minutes long. Take a look at what they produced this year.
So, Sherman died.
Hey, what's up? Love your hair, by the way. What's up, Ginger? How's Ronnie doing? Hey, good to see you guys.
So, where's the cake?
Why is he setting up right?
I think that's what he requested.
To be a vampire.
I'm not sure where to start. This tragedy that has shaken this community and torn the school apart is something that I don't think any of us should ever have to go through.
How did he die anyway? I heard it was a house fire and he was horribly mangled beyond recognition.
I heard he jumped in front of a grenade, saving hundreds of children's lives at a Justin Bieber concert.
Thank you.
All right, before we begin, we're going to go off topic real quick. We've got Trent Jones here. He's going to come speak to you guys real quick, so give him your attention.
Thank you. Let's hear it from Mr. Sherman. I actually did not come here for this moment, but now that I have the opportunity, I think it's critical to say that the most important thing we invest in is you, no doubt about it. The work that you do is unbelievable. Please give yourselves a hand. And from the bottom of my heart, one of the greatest things that's ever happened to me in my life, after my family and my kids, is the great Travis Sherman. He's my friend, he's my brother, and he's your teacher, and our community, our state, and our nation is so lucky for him. Let's give him one more round. Thank you, guys. Keep working so hard. You make Springdale so proud, and I am so honored to work with you. Thank you.
Okay, back to this. One of the things that we all look forward to, our students at least look forward to the most, is our national competition, Student Television Network. And what happens is I select a group of students who have shown dedication to the program, have worked hard throughout their time here, and I feel will represent Har-Ber and the state of Arkansas to the best of their ability. This year, students had the amazing opportunity to go to Seattle, an incredible place. They saw the Seattle Space Needle. They saw the Skagit Valley Tulip Fields, or the Dirt Fields. The Rock and Roll Museum, plus competed with students across the nation, worked with industry leaders and colleagues, and hopefully walked away with a little more motivation and inspiration. Here's a little recap of their week.
This is our last goodbye. Don't come and find me. So hard to see you cry, please. Somebody blind me, 'cause I can feel it. I'm still hanging on to every word. My heart is beating, and I'm sorry that I left you hurt.
Said, "Hey champ, why would you do that?" He may remember it differently. Anyway, it was months later that he told me that story in a much darker scenario. And he said, after that night, I wasn't sure if I could do this, but I'm so glad I stuck with it. And I think that is a solid point. This industry is extremely difficult. It takes a lot of hard work and perseverance to work in this industry, and he has demonstrated that on a daily basis, even when he loses $24,000 worth of equipment in Seattle. I haven't forgotten. This year's Broadcast Journalist of the Year goes to Nick Luttrell.
I'm Nick Luttrell.
Where are you going? All right. There's no doubt we have produced amazing content throughout this year, some of the best to date. We could literally be here for hours watching all this content produced. For the sake of your time, I've narrowed it down to just a few that I thought there was no specific category, but I still felt that they should be shown tonight. All the following student productions have placed in competition statewide throughout the year.
What is Skills USA? Photography, welding, carpentry, cosmetology, and many more. Find your passion with the snap of your fingers. Skills USA, champions at work, it's as easy as a snap.
There's over 10,000 chemicals found in cigarettes, all of them affecting your ability to breathe. So with just one puff, your lungs are inhaling poisons like carbon monoxide, arsenic, ammonia, methylamine, and butane. Next time you light a cigarette, think about it. Visit sosprojectprevent.com for more information.
What is pain? What is pain to you? Do you understand? Do you even know what pain is? Stop running from it. Embrace the pain that you're gonna feel when you're trying to do something great. Let's change what follows our I am. I am successful. I am powerful. I am great. I am amazing. What follows your I am is going to shape your day, your year, and your life. I am great. I am amazing.
Greatness comes pain.
Pain can't be your enemy, it has to be your friend. You have to learn to embrace that pain. You have to learn to dig deep. When you feel that pain in your heart, when you feel that pain in your leg, the pain in your arm, you gotta learn to push through, dig a little bit deeper. Just know that the other person on the other side that wants to conquer you, wants to defeat you, is going through the same thing. Who's gonna win? Who's gonna impress their will upon the next man, the next woman, the next person that's gonna struggle through the pain? On the other side of pain,
greatness. Are you all in? Are you ready to sacrifice? No more excuses. Get it done.
How bad do you want to be great?
Did you hear about Trump's address the other day?
No, what happened?
He shut down the whole government.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
You shouldn't be smoking those. Those are like really bad for you.
I mean, you're more likely to get hit by a car than to die from smoking cigarettes.
Whatever.
Dang it, he just gave me his number.
Dying from smoking cigarettes is more likely than you think. Visit Project Prevent to learn more.
Hey, how's it going? Yes?
I buy all the cigarettes in the world.
Can I see ID? Cute. Why do you want to buy all the cigarettes?
So my dad can stop smoking.
Smoking affects the one you love. Visit Project Prevent to learn more.
Life moves at a fast pace. Sometimes we forget to slow down and take a closer look. Skills USA is about discovering your passion, your talent. If you speed through life, you might miss the process. Take a closer look at the people behind the brick they lay or the house they build. Preparing students to be job ready from day one out of high school. Skills USA, champions at work.
3 years ago, I met Sherman and he changed my life for the better. He changed all of our lives for the better. He taught us to laugh. He taught us to dream. But most importantly, he taught us that when things get hard, that's right, you give up.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? The amazing Pareja is now going to demonstrate to you all the powers from beyond.
I love you.
I told you to wait in the car.
You're my best friend.
You're embarrassing me.
Tonight,
I will...
It's 11 a.m.
Fine. This morning...
Can you still really call it morning, though? It's technically closer to the
guys,
afternoon right now.
Guys, seriously?
Sorry.
I first learned of this trick from the depths of the Nantucket, where they used it to conjure Satan himself.
Boring.
Seriously? Fine. I need a volunteer.
Ooh, me, pick me. I'm right here. Pick me.
Anyone?
Me. Pick Lily. Me.
Anyone?
Fine. Me.
Thank you, madam.
So close.
I will need your phone for this trick.
No.
I need your phone.
No.
I can't do this trick without your phone.
Here.
Thank you. I will now need you to examine this phone to make sure it is an ordinary, regular phone.
Yep, it's phone.
Alrighty. And now, I will
Chris, please don't do what I think you're about to do.
Did Lance Armstrong think before he went to the moon?
No, but Neil Armstrong did for several years.
Exactly, really, that's what I thought.
Be like it owes you something.
Thank you. Thank you.
Wow.
Now, madam, I'll need you to check the phone to make sure it is completely broken.
Yep, it's broken.
And now, I summon the powers of the Dark Lord himself. Abracadabra, alakazam! I hope you love this phone, because it went bam bam! Uh-oh.
Jules, whose phone was that?
Hey guys, you see my phone?
I think I saw T-Dog walk away with it, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
That's weird. Alright, you guys have fun.
Sherman's gonna kill us.
Really? I think I can still make it work. All I need is some rice, some lubricant, and my grandma's dentures.
Chris, I swear to God, if you touch anything else, I will make you disappear.
Well, look! How was I supposed to know? In the movie, they made it look so easy!
Wait, did you watch Now You See Me last night?
Yeah, we watched it together. Chris, you know that's not real, right?
Really? Man, they're so convincing.
So what are we gonna do now?
I've got an idea.
Your part gets me every single time. Filmmaking is one of the more popular routes students take at Har-Ber, but one of the more difficult. It's not simply great shooting or good storytelling or having good audio. It's a combination of everything falling into harmony. Acting, storytelling, camera lighting, editing, directing, producing. It's so crucial that all these roles are in perfect sync. This year's best film goes to a group that dedicated time outside of school hours and went above and beyond. The final product is a great reflection of their hard work. This year's best film goes to Jade Farmer, Alexander Chavez, Charlotte McCorder, Gentry Spresser, Chris Perea, Hannah Maggard, and Rachel Peters.
Pay attention. Are you listening? I'm only going to say this once. We're going on a trip. It's going to be rough. It's going to feel like it's going on for a long time, so it's going to be hard to stay alert. But you have to do every single thing I tell you, or we won't make it. Do you understand? Under no circumstance will you take off your blindfold. Do you understand? If you hear something, you tell me. But if you take your blindfold off, you will die. Do you understand me? Everybody ready? Blindfolds on.
It sounds amazing, though. I have to see it.
No, Gentry!
Okay, stay quiet and keep moving.
Charlotte!
Stay together. Just look
up. Dance.
Well, listen, we already have two of those.
Mary Alexa.
That's so 2010. We're not falling for it.
Red Dragon.
Huh? Red Dragon? Charlotte, don't listen. It's a lie.
But it's 5K at 96 frames per second.
No one shoots in 5K.
I have to look.
Charlotte, no!
You're gone!
Chris, focus!
They're all gone!
Stay with me!
I can't focus! I don't know
Chris,
if I can
stay
do
with
it!
Me.
I can't!
Stay with me! Breaking news. Mallory Bird, one of the last remaining survivors of
And we are live. Ready to? That leaves the remaining population
at just go under 100, to? With the most densely populated area being Canada. With numbers like that, it brings a whole new meaning to one in a million. Eh?
Camera 3, can you iris up for me, please? Thank you, that looks good.
Well, that about wraps it up. From all two of us here at Har-Ber Wildcat News and the rest of you 97 out there, we bid farewell. And remember, keep those blindfolds on and those ears closed. For HBWN, I'm Jade Farmer. We'll see you never.
All right, this is a new one that I've added this year, which I call Most Likely to Make the Cut. This award goes to a student that has shown tremendous growth, demonstrates leadership on a daily basis, and is one that I would say is most likely to succeed in this industry. Tonight, I want to recognize an individual who I'm so proud of because she not only found a love and passion for something, but she discovered a lot about herself during the process. I remember when she first came into the program, she did it because of a friend. But then she felt, then something sparked inside of her, and she found something to look forward to each day and escape when she needed it. A lot of these students look to her for guidance, for inspiration, for leadership, and I think we're all going to miss her, but I can't wait to see the work she does in the future. This year's Most Likely to Make the Cut goes to Charlotte McCorder.
Growing up, life teaches you so many lessons. The hardest lesson of all is to realize that everything happens for a reason. As I look back on all the things that have caused me such doubt and rejection, I've realized that they've only made me appreciate everything else so much more.
There is a house built out of stone. Wooden floors, walls, and windows.
So, were you going to say goodbye this morning or what?
Sorry, I was just in a hurry. Plus, you guys seem kind of busy.
Busy? I mean, we were just talking about the move and everything.
Sorry. Well, I have to go to school. Class is about to start.
I think we should talk about this.
We can, I promise. I'll talk to you later. I have to go.
I used to think that every hardship made me a worse person. That everything I went through would only pull me further away from everything I could ever possibly find pleasurable. I blamed other people for the reason I would never find joy. I felt as if I was always on the outside looking in. That nobody else knew what it was like to be surrounded by constant arguing and insecurities. That nobody would ever truly love me. Or that I could never truly love anyone else, or even myself, quite honestly. I've never been much of an optimist, but I have finally found a way to look at things from a different perspective. I learned who I was. I learned that I couldn't become myself by impressing the people around me or blaming the people from my past that hurt me. I'm not saying that it was easy or that I just woke up one morning with all the confidence and love in the world, because I didn't. I had to learn that I myself will never be like anyone else. That I couldn't continue to compare myself to anyone else's lives. And that's what gives me purpose. Ground had a rose and passed.
I'm very proud of what you've done. I got you this because I hope it helps you along your next journey. All right. As this event continues to grow, we are very proud to be able to network with professionals and past students to continue to offer opportunities to students who have excelled through this program and have a passion to be in this industry. One of those students is here tonight and was, in fact, a past legacy. He has gone on to do some incredible things, including working with one of the nation's best photographers, traveling all over the country, creating content, capturing unforgettable moments, and it all started right here. I'll never forget the very first time I met him, and this is actually a true story. He'll tell it. He walked in, he reached out his hand, and he said, "Hi, I'm Brandon Bucherri." And I reached out and I shook his hand, and without letting go, I looked him in the eyes and I said, "Do you feel that?" And he said, "No." And I said, "Do you know what that is?" He said, "Nope." I said, "That's greatness." And take a look at his work.
With you, I fell in love the way you fall asleep. Slowly and then all at once. It's simple. I love you. I love your selflessness. I love your spontaneity. Your energy, your ambition, your creativity.
When I look into your beautiful blue eyes and see your smile that lights up the room, I can't help but feel in the core of my being the same feelings that light up my heart and give me true joy.
Before I met you, I didn't know it was possible to love someone the way that I love you. You're a blessing. You are genuine. You are kind. You are big-hearted. You are loved. You're my very best friend. And you're about to be my husband.
There's nothing in this world worthy enough to give you on this day except for these words. They encompass exactly how I feel about you. You are the reason why I have believed, why I still believe, and why I will continue to believe.
I can't tell you how excited I am to see you walk down that aisle in your dress.
You have the ability to speak to my heart with a single glance, to let me know that everything will be fine because we have each other.
The last 5 years have been amazing, and I think the next 50 will be even better.
I grow with you, I laugh with you, I will always love my life with you.
You and me and you, from today to forever, I'm so in love with you. I can't wait to find more things to love about you each and every day.
Could not be more excited and thrilled to be marrying you. You bring color to my black and white. We're gonna have a blast again.
Please help me in welcoming Brandon Bucherri.
Hey everybody. Before I get into my spiel, your dad wanted me to do this, Peyton. Happy birthday, Peyton Locke, if wherever you're at. I don't know. Maybe you're not here. That's okay. Yeah. Thanks for having me out tonight. This evening's really special to me. Mr. Sherman started this whole awards thing after I graduated, unfortunately, so I never got to be a part of this, but I think it's really cool. I'm a graduate of the Har-Ber TV program myself, and ever since my time here, I've been blessed with incredible opportunities to create films and commercials all over the world. I've shot weddings across the country. We've expanded globally now, and I've gotten to work with companies like Walmart, the Salvation Army, Dr. Pepper, Toyota, and starting to work with more. So it all started right down the hall in E107. I'm extremely proud of the work that I've seen coming from this program. So much so that myself and the MWB team, Miles Up Warrior team, have decided to partner with the HBTV program this year for a unique opportunity. As a team, we watched countless hours of content created by all of you. And tonight, I'm here to give an opportunity for one of you to begin taking the next step in the journey that is filmmaking. So all of us at MWB have decided that one student will be given an internship this summer with our team. That'll include shooting alongside myself at one of our biggest weddings of the year, assisting with creating a commercial for a local company, and learning valuable skills like marketing yourself and expanding your portfolio. I'll also be personally mentoring this student in all the different aspects of pre-production, editing, and color grading, and the use of lighting and camera techniques, all the stuff that goes into it. But before I present our selection, I'd like to say how proud I am to have come from this program and how excited I am to see you all taking this to new heights. So give yourselves a round of applause. I'm excited to announce that the internship will be awarded to...
As a human being, it's a constant challenge to prove yourself. It's easy to get lost in the doubt and fall into the dark. But this is where I found myself. This life is like a game. I am a filmmaker. I found a passion that drives me to be myself and allows me to express my ideas that will one day change the world and all the people in it that once doubted me. Find yourself and never be afraid to be different than the rest. Leave no doubt.
Congratulations to Charlotte McCorder.
All right. That's something very special. And for me, the only thing that I told Brandon and Miles was that I wanted to be completely separate from it. I wanted them to look at the content created this past year and judge it without knowing who created it and choose this person without my influence. They watched hours of content from this year, and when I asked who they had chosen, he said, there was a lot of great videos, but the one that really stood out above all others was Charlotte. She has a natural talent for this, and it's something that you can't teach, only fine-tune and make better. I think that's a very nice compliment. Congratulations again, Charlotte. Okay, we're wrapping up. Our final award of the night is the Legacy Award. This award goes to the student that has left a lasting impression on the program. The award is a plaque that they will receive, as well as a duplicate, which will go in the classroom so that future students may look to these students and see who has truly shaped this program. This year was difficult. I had three outstanding students that I felt could go on to represent Har-Ber. So to honor these students, I wanted to show you their portfolio so you know how tough of a decision this truly was. Here are the top three nominees.
See you shine in the night like a diamond, you are. I'm good on the side, it's alright, just hold me in the dark. Cause I live down the street, it's all we need. When you need it, it's yours, all I is. And nothing feels
Photography is the art of creating masterpieces with a camera, but it's so much more than that. Film and broadcast has given me an outlet to find myself and to figure out what I stand for. In our world, people will try to tell you who you are, what to think, and what to do.